Welcome to my channel Chemistry with the DNA. I am Noman Ahmed and today we are going to start lecture number 8 of thermodynamics and today we are going to start the topic heat. What is heat and how do we define heat? Actually heat is nothing but exchange of energy between between system and surrounding. So heat is exchange of energy between system and surrounding. And if somebody asks from you another definition, so it is actually transfer of energy. The condition is when there is temperature difference. So when there is exchange of transfer of energy, when there is a transfer of difference of temperature, that is called heat. So this is very important. Heat is exchange of energy between these two things. System, anything under observation, under instigation is called system, and except system, rest part of the universe is called surrounding. Okay, so this is very simple. Now what is the symbol of heat? The symbol of heat is, is Q. It is represented by capital Q. In some books you might have seen it is represented by small q as well. And it's a unit is joule. And common unit is calorie. And 1 calorie is equal to, here I will write, 1 calorie is equal to 4.182 joule. This is something very important. So 1 calorie is equal to, this is C, this is not C, this is calorie. 1 calorie is equal to 4.182 joule. So these are the two things which we discuss here. The first one, heat is exchange of energy between system and surrounding, exchange of transfer of energy when there is temperature difference, and the symbol of heat is Q, its unit is joule, and some common units is also 1 calorie. Here we can say calorie. 1 calorie is equal to 4.182 joule. This is something very important. Now you have to remember two important things. Two important statement which you need to remember. Number one, heat given by the system and heat given to the system. Second one, so suppose we have a system. This is a kind of system. If you want to increase its energy, So there are two options. In the previous lecture, we just discussed two options. Number one, just supply heat. Heat is given. Just supply heat to the system and its temperature will rise, its energy will increase. Number one, work done on the system. Just perform work on the system. But here, now see, when heat given by the system, when we heat performs the work, so we can say it is a heat given by the system, that is negative. And heat given to the system, when we supply heat to the system, that it becomes a positive. So these two things are very much important. These two statements are very important. Whenever heat is provided to the system, heat is given to the system, that is positive, because we just increase its energy, so that's why that is written in positive. When heat and that system performs action to the surrounding or some outside the system, so that system performs the work, so that's why its energy decreases, so we will write it negative, because this is by, there are difference between these two words, by and to. Heat given by the system, so that will be negative. When it, and when system performs the work, that is negative. But when we perform action or work on the system, so that is positive, and it is a negative. So these two things are very much important. Okay, this was two important things. Now come to the next same topic, but the next point, specific heat capacities of gases. Specific heat capacity of gases. In short, we can write it in a bracket. I will write specific heat capacity, or simply we can say HHC, specific heat capacity of gases. What is specific heat capacity of gases? Okay, we have discussed two processes, that is number one, isothermal process, and the second one was adiabatic process. These two processes we discussed, adiabatic process and isothermal process. Okay, what is specific heat capacity? If just to define it, specific heat capacity is denoted by the symbol C. Okay, is it nothing but amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass by a unit degree rise in temperature. So this is basically amount of heat required to raise the temperature. This is heat, this is a mass, this is difference in temperature. So amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass by 1 degree rise in temperature is called a specific heat capacity. This is very much important. Like what will be the unit? The unit of specific heat capacity will be, now see, Q, it is a heat is written in joule, and M, gram, and delta T is centigrade. So this is the unit of joule. Like water has specific heat capacity 4.25 gram per centigrade. It is the specific heat capacity of water. We can say specific heat capacity of water. What does it mean? It means for 1 gram of water, if its temperature increases up to 1 degree, we have to provide 4.2 joule energy. 4.25 joule energy is required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water up to 1 degree. So that's why it is fixed and very important for objective type. For objective, it is very, very important. Our MCQ, it is very, very important. Okay, this is specific heat capacity. at isothermal process. Now see, in isothermal process, temperature is constant. Temperature is constant. Yeah, we can say delta T is equal to zero. And adiabatic process, heat is constant, means adiabatic process, no heat exchange will happen. So we can say an adiabatic Q is equal to constant. Yeah, simply we can say Q is equal to zero. If Q is equal to zero, mean ke heat, there is no heat exchange, there will be no heat exchange, there is no heat exchange. Remember the word no heat exchange. So that's why it is adiabatic process. So what will be, now see, in isothermic process, suppose this is for isothermic process, what will be the, for isothermal the specific heat capacity will be, now see, if temperature is constant, delta T is zero. So if this is infinity, if this is zero, so it will the isothermal for specific heat isothermal process will be infinity. And if Q is zero, so this will for adiabatic specific heat capacity will be zero. Now these two things are very important. The specific heat capacity of gases can be zero and can be infinity. Yani we can say for every gas there is a different specific heat capacity, but it is from zero to infinity. Some gases have zero, some gases 1, 2, or some gases have infinity, means that it is anything. So this is very much important and you need to remember this thing. Okay, specific heat capacity at constant volume and at constant pressure, that is very, very important. These are two cases for these two things are important, but we have to remember two cases, two specific heat capacity of gases. So what are those? Let me write. Okay, what are they? At constant volume and at constant pressure. Number one, at constant volume. Number two, at constant pressure. So these two specific heat capacities of gases are very important. We'll be dealing with this at constant volume and constant pressure. So what is this at constant volume? What is specific heat capacity? Specific heat capacity at constant volume and specific heat capacity at constant pressure. So at constant volume, what? At constant volume means specific heat capacity at constant volume and specific heat capacity at constant pressure. Okay. So if at constant volume, what was the previous formula? Now see this formula, C is equal to Q M delta T. We will modify this formula into these two terms. Like for constant volume, we will be using Cv at Q and M delta T. This is at specific, whenever the at constant volume, when at constant volume, it's what will be the unit of this? Of course, the unit will be, what will be the unit of Cv? Joule, gram centigrade. These are the unit at constant volume. But at constant pressure, how can we write this? We will just change from Cv to Cp, because at constant pressure we will be, at constant volume we will be using Cv, and in constant pressure we will be using Cp. So Q upon M delta T. So what will be the unit? The unit will be joule gram per centigrade. This will be the unit at okay, what does it mean? What does it at constant, how can we define it? It means 1 gram of gas, amount of heat required to increase 1 gram of heat up to 1 degree rise in temperature is called at specific heat capacity at constant volume. At constant volume, the amount of heat required to increase 1 gram of gas up to 1 degree rise in temperature is called specific heat capacity at a constant volume. And the same, what is specific heat capacity at constant pressure will be 1 gram of gas, the amount of temperature required to increase its temperature up to 1 degree rise in temperature at constant pressure. So this is at constant pressure and constant temperature. Because amount of heat is required to increase the temperature, so we can say here Q is equal to, in this case, Q is equal to Cv, and in this case, Q is equal to Cp. So this is very much important terms at constant volume and at constant pressure. So this is the term we'll be using in two specific heat capacity of gases. So this is very important. At constant volume, this formula is modified. This is the specific heat constant. But we will not be using these specific heat capacity of capacity of gases. We'll be using molar heat capacity. This is very much important. So we are going to write, let me remove all these stuffs, but what is, we will be using molar heat capacity of gases. So this term will be used now to molar heat capacity at constant volume and at constant pressure. What is molar heat capacity of gases? Let me define it. The definition will be amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole. This is very important because molar mean 1 mole. 1 mole of a gas, 1 mole of a gas, the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas up to 1 degree rise in temperature. 1 mole of a gas up to 1 degree rise in temperature is called molar heat capacity. So this formula will be a bit modified. Like it can be used, C will be Q N delta T. And where, what is N? N means 1 mole of a gas. So at constant pressure and at constant volume, the formula will be modified to Q and delta T will be at constant volume, and at constant pressure the formula will be modified at constant pressure. So these two formulas are very, very, very much important according to thermodynamics in lecture number 8. So as we discussed some important formulas in this video lecture, I hope you enjoyed the video, but don't go anywhere, because in next coming video we'll be talking about the relationship between Cp and Cv. Take a very good care of yourself. Good luck. Take care. Assalamu alaikum.